Exploiting their personality is crucial to achieve your personal goals. Skills used against immunities will not succeed and leave you exhausted. Meanwhile, exploited vulnerabilities will give you one effort point back. Okay, so a little bit of a strategic maneuvering here. It says review immunities and vulnerabilities in your journal tab in the menu. And we just revealed an immunity and we just revealed a vulnerability. So...
Emily, please excuse my insisting, but you still haven't answered about my mother. Do you know her?
You'll see, Louis. Everybody here knows Sarah de Richet.
I don't know where we're going like this, Emily, but you're connected to my mother one way or another. And if I can believe my vision, you don't have much of a place in her heart.
Alright, you obtain talents when carrying out certain actions. Remember to review their unlock conditions and effects, as they offer very interesting improvements. Review all talents in the tab in the menu. In the dictated tab in the menu. Okay. Let's see, there's the map. There's the journal. Oh, okay. Interesting. Character. There's all my talents and my traits. Okay. We'll dive more into that later. For now, though, let's continue.
Good evening, sir. May I ask your name, please?
Louis Moras de Richet.
Monsieur de Richet, delighted to welcome you among us, sir. You must be Sarah de Richet's son. I must tell you, we are doing our utmost.
Dude, looks like somebody from the Court of Owls. Let's ask about the mother.
What can you tell me about the disappearance of my mother?
2 weeks have passed since Sir's mother went missing. All the staff here have since been busy searching every nook and cranny of the island. But sir, may rest assured, we shouldn't be long in finding her.
And just what have you found so far?
It would seem that Sir's mother may be hiding on the island and regularly changing her location. But no one seems to know why she would find this behavior necessary.
What do you mean?
On several occasions, we have found leftovers of food, a few of her things, or even traces of campsites.
The reason why we're
searching the wharf again is
so she's not necessarily missing, she just might be running around doing something.
Indeed, sir. According to our information, lights were seen in the middle of the night, sir. After verification, none of the guests seemed to have left the manor last night. We think that perhaps Sir's mother was here.
Okay.
And
let's do that.
Did you find anything then?
We discovered a certain amount of damage, sir, on the wooden part of the wharf.
What type of damage?
Broken barrels, mainly. We'll do whatever is necessary to have them rapidly repaired. But quite frankly, I can't imagine what Sir's mother would have been doing with them.
What could Mother have been doing with barrels?
Nevertheless, our search of the wharf hasn't been entirely
blown them up, maybe?
Successful.
I don't know.
What do you mean?
We seem to have found an object that would appear to belong to Sir's mother. A handkerchief. The handkerchief is embroidered with the initials... S.D.R.
Oh, it looks like that same one from, in his vision.
Sarah de Richet. I have orders to give it to Lord Mortimer as soon as I see him.
I know my mother. She's not the kind to go for a midnight stroll on the wharf for nothing. I've got to find out what the hell she was doing here.
Where exactly did you find the handkerchief?
On the landing dock, sir. The one you arrived by.
Give me the handkerchief. I'll personally show it to Lord Mortimer.
Well,
I've traveled hard for several days in order to get here.
Yes, but...
Invited by your master.
No, of course,
because my mother went missing right under your nose.
Sir, please.
And having only just arrived, you refused to give me her personal belongings?
Of course not, sir. It was never my intention to contradict, sir. Here you are. I must return. There's still much to prepare in order to welcome all the
guests. Okay, cool. Starting to get the hang of this.
It is indeed your handkerchief, Mother. must have come here for a specific reason. I need to know what it is. Let's think. What could she have been doing out here on this wharf?
And R2 lets me move faster. There we go. Alright.
Must be an incredible view from up there. Impossible to set foot on the island without being seen from 300 meters away.
Okay. Interesting. And what else?
This chest might belong to Duchess Hillsborough.
Okay.
Honey, I couldn't have hoped for better.
Huh. Okay. And what have we got here?
It's like a bar from an old gate.
This I thought it was a crowbar.
It's been broken fairly recently. The edges are still clean, and the tip is blackened. Without analysis to the contrary, I put my money on cannon powder.
Let's go ahead and take it.
This might just come in handy.
I might regret that later, but
it's an open.
We'll see.
Since you have used any.
We'll see. What do we got here?
It's like the barrel's been broken for quite some time.
Probably the same ones that old boy was talking about earlier. Let's see. Anything else worth? Oh. Royal jelly. Okay. Oh.
Some rope. Apparently no one's touched it for a good long time.
Okay. What else do we got here? Okay, can't get in the boat.
Let's see what's hidden inside.
Find a clue.
One of the letters is stamped with the seal of the order. And I recognize your handwriting anywhere, Mother. But who is this Samuel Ritter of Doshua? Who are you writing to? I don't recognize the name. Let's see what's inside this letter. So.
Dear Samuel, my stay on Lord Mortimer's island is going wonderfully well. As I find myself in such charming company, I plan to stay a few more weeks. Would you be so kind as to send me a gift that I'd like to give to our old friend Manuel Godoy? I would be most grateful. I have been told that he is going to join us here soon. I would like to mark the occasion. Thank you in advance. Yours devotedly, Sarah Faustine de Richet.
What is your game here, Mother? Secrets, always more secrets. You never talk to anyone using language like this. Something's going on here. Who is this Samuel Ritter? And for crying out loud, who is this Manuel Godoy that you keep bringing up? Think. Godoy. Manuel Godoy. Why does the name sound so familiar? I'm guessing his name has some importance. Spanish, I'd say. But just can't put a face to it. Well, hope we meet to talk about it soon, Mother. I don't know what you've gotten yourself into this time, but I'll bet you've got a lot to tell me.
All right. And what else is over here? Oh.
A lantern. Nothing special.
Okay, I thought I could take it with me. But I guess not. Alright, unless I'm missing something, I think that might be everything. So, let's go ahead and press on.
Latin inscription. Annesis. Mifili quantilia produncia mundus orgatum.
I have no idea what that means. and apparently neither does he.
How did Mortimer manage to build his manor at the top of a rocky outcrop?
I don't know. Or something.
Whoa. Impressive.
Yeah.
Ah, my son. I was looking for you.
What can I do for you, Your Eminence?
I wanted to ask you. You are the son of Sara Derice, aren't you? You see, your mother and I were supposed to meet here on this very spot. I was supposed to hand her a very important envelope. But I haven't seen her.
If only Mother had told me why she was coming here. Anyway, I ought to take the envelope. It might have something to do with her disappearance.
Listen, if it will help, you can always give it to me.
Thank you, my son. I'll bear that in mind. I'd rather deal with her direct. Don't take it personally. Would you happen to know if your mother has arrived yet?
Okay, so we have 3 blunders left.
Certainly, Your Eminence. Mother got here some time ago. I was hoping to find her when I arrived, but given the hour, she must be asleep by now.
Right. I shall see her tomorrow.
By the way, Your Eminence, I wasn't aware you knew my mother.
Ah, if you only knew my son. I hold your mother in the highest regard. She has rendered great service to the church. Help us in life. I hope that you will follow in her footsteps.
Only she had told me where she was headed.
Nonetheless, our exchanges have always been discreet, and I should like them to remain as such. If your mother wishes to speak to you about us one day, I will not mind if she does.
That is commendable. But as we work together on a daily basis, it is surely just an oversight.
Most certainly. You said you work together. What do you do exactly?
Let's go ahead and tell him.
My mother and I belong to the same secret organization, the Golden Order, which I joined a few years ago. Mother trained me, and I assist in her research. In other words, you can trust me.
My child, you are telling a perfect stranger that you and your mother work for a secret society. It would seem that discretion is not one of your specialities. You
I
will understand
that,
that it does not encourage me to put my trust in you.
Crap.
Shit.
All the same, it bothers me to see you in a quandary, Your Eminence. Is there any other solution? Look, if it's of any help, you can always leave your envelope with me and I'll give it to her as soon as I see her.
I hesitate. Up till now, we have always dealt with her in person, and that has always been successful.
All right, come on, don't mess this one up.
Do you think I should give it to you?
Let's do this one.
Only you know that, Your Eminence. If you're asking me if you can trust me, or if I can keep a secret, I would answer yes, absolutely.
I understand.
In truth, it all depends on the nature of the contents of your letter.
It is a list of names.
This list must be of extreme importance.
Ah, if only you knew. It's a list of people that your mother must help. Listen to me. If I give you the letter, can you promise me before God that no one other than your mother will help?
says the last step of a confrontation will repeat itself if you fail. Okay, good. Let's do no worries.
I swear by the Almighty God to honor the promise that no one but my mother shall cast her gaze upon your letter.
Good. Listen,
okay.
Let's stop that. I'm going to tell you a secret, Monsieur Lucci. Your mother and I are organizing the escape of a large number of French priests who face a massacre organized by the accursed.
Go back to the group near the chimney.
The church is literally being bled like a beast. Without your mother, hundreds of men in the cloth have gone to the guillotine. She has made the services of your order available to us by organizing the priests' safe passage across the borders. Even if she does not share all our convictions, she always provided assistance. Young man, you can be proud of me, her son. Be it only for her sake. Always respect your name. Here, the letter I spoke of. It includes a list of about 15 names ready for departure. Be quick. Remember to tell Sarah when you see him. That time is short.
Well played. I'll decide later when I'm alone whether to look at what it contains.
Okay. Hidden elements. Many clues and items are hidden. Some of them will have an impact on your adventure, so do not hesitate to look for them. Sure thing. Alright, so the letter's sealed, but we probably shouldn't be looking at it right now in the open, so let's look around.
Lord Mortimer certainly has a taste for staging rumors. Lord Mortimer certainly has a taste for staging rumors.
Huh. I was like, okay, can I do something there, or... Alright, what else? Anything over here? Nope. Thorn grants you exalted state. You temporarily see the immunities affecting a dialogue choice in a conversation. But I can only carry 5, so I'll have to be careful about how I use these. Alright, let's see what's going on over here with everybody else. Oh. But first...
Lives of the Noble Greeks and Romans by Plutarch. A biography of the great men.
No, let's just take it. Okay. We'll look at that later, too.
I thought my chimney was big, but this one is beyond belief.
It's the least one can say. I've been longing for a warm fire for ages.
Since I set foot on the island, I haven't ventured more than 2 yards away from it.
Have you also just arrived?
Oh, late morning, I'd say.
Louis, come join us.
That lip syncing is really bad.
Monsieur, may I introduce you to Monsignor, His Eminence, Cardinal Piatti. He joins us straight from Rome.
Oh, just call me
from Roma.
It's simple.
George Washington. President of the United States.
Oh, snap! Okay.
Delighted at last to make your acquaintance, Mr. President.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. President. Louis Moras de Richer. It is an honor to meet you.
Young man, let's keep it simple, please. Let us forget our fancy titles. Nice to meet you, Louis.
I should imagine you never thought you'd be in such company.
I must admit that I didn't. It's the first time that I've ever met so many illustrious personalities.
And you haven't seen anything yet. Generally, when Lord Mortimer organizes one of his receptions, there are over a dozen people here.
They can't all be here yet. And you'll see, most of the time there's only the upper crust.
And I noticed you were already getting to know His Eminence at the entrance. It's the perfect place to build up a network. What were you talking about, if you forgive my indiscretion?
About my mother.
At the risk of disappointing you, we weren't conspiring in our corners. His Eminence was simply telling me that he knew my mother and how much he held her in high esteem.
It so happens that Monsieur Derice's mother is to join us.
Oh, pity. No scrumptious gossip or juicy tidbits, unmentionable secrets, or even money matters. But you'll see, it will come. Despite all the goodwill in the world, you can't stop people scheming left and right around here.
It's like a high school clique.
Well, my friends, do any of you know the reason why we're here this time?
Not in the slightest. As for me, I've been invited by Sir Horn, a close friend of Lord Mortimer, but I do not know the reason why.
You see, Louis, every time Lord Mortimer organizes a reception, he always finds a moment to set up a chat with all the guests.
During which time we remake the world.
Accompanied by gallons of absinthe and cussing, I'll leave you to imagine the result.
So, if I understand rightly, Monsieur Derice, you've come out here to join your mother. For what reason, exactly?
Invent something.
Like you, Mr. President, I'm here as a result of Lord Mortimer's invitation.
Two members of the same family? That is rare.
You know what they say. You can pick your nose, but you can't pick your family.
Seriously, though, I know your mother well. Stay behind with me afterwards, and we'll take a moment to speak about her.
What? Good evening, how did it fail? I was right on it.
Shit. That's the man from my vision.
An urgent case has delayed our host, Lord Mortimer. He can't be present this evening, and he sends his deepest apologies.
What, is he sick?
He hasn't even turned up. Great start. Do you know that man?
Sir Gregory Hole, an English aristocrat. Very influential. He's also close to Lord Mortimer. So don't be surprised if he acts like he's
at home. Excuse me.
And now, my dear guests, a light meal is served in the small salon. For those who
light.
Like, you're
invited. I'd be like, bruh, I want some heavy food.
My dear fellow, you must have read my thoughts. I shall follow.
We'll have to be careful not to make too much noise. One of Lord Mortimer's guests is relaxing.
Oh, how's anybody supposed to relax looking at you?
Don't take it the wrong way, sir, but I have already eaten. Thus, I shall be happy to remain by the fireside.
If you don't mind, Gregory, I should like to keep Mr. Washington company.
Please feel at home. And you, sir?
If I stay with Washington, we'll be able to speak about my mother. But on the other hand, I'd like to learn more about this home. I saw it in my vision.
Yeah, let's go ahead and, do this one.
Let's follow home.
I'll follow you, sir. Mr. Washington, I hope to speak with you at greater length on another occasion. Emily, please excuse me, but I would like to speak to Sir Holm. I shall see you later.
My friend, I hope our dear Giovanni is well.
The troubles in France are fatiguing, but he would recover slowly. Do not fear. He apologizes for remaining in Rome. The voyage was too much for him.
And right he was, too. The mildness of the Mediterranean. Come, sit down and have something to eat, my friend. You look rather pale. Excuse me, sir. I have been neglecting my duty. I haven't introduced myself. Sir Gregory Hole, an old friend of Lord Mortimer's.
A real pleasure, sir.
You who must be well used to the court of France. How do you find this peaceful little haven?
Charming, if I hadn't come here for disturbing reasons.
Yes, I heard the news. What a story.
Indeed. I wanted to ask you. You seem to know my mother well. Is that true?
Who does not know of her, sir? She has such a wide circle that everyone knows your mother from a distance or closer.
Everyone knows Sarah, son.
But you only know her by her reputation.
I remember she once worked for the Crown of England, and she always honors her engagement. However, we have never been personally introduced, sir.
Well, if I'm to believe my vision, you're not going to get along with her.
Thank you for your answer, Sir Home. But I beg your pardon.
Dang, so we might have made the wrong choice then.
Have we met?
Except in my dreams, of course.
Not that I remember yet. Perhaps you are mistaking me for another member of the Chamber of Lords. And what with the wig and the powder, it wouldn't be the first time.
No, you were definitely the one I saw threatening my mother.
Never mind. It'll come back.
Would you allow
one last question, sir? I don't want to take up all your time.
Please go ahead. What do you want to know?
Yeah, what did she come here for?
Do you know the reason for my mother's presence here?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Crap.
She was invited by Lord Morton.
But you don't know why.
Not really. I was given to understand that your mother was looking for something.
And do you know how long my mother and Lord Mortimer have known each other?
Several years, I believe. They seem to know each other for quite a while. But it was the first time that Lord Mortimer had invited her to join us here.
Good. And finally, would it be possible for me to speak with Lord Mortimer this evening?
I'm terribly sorry, no. He really is quite unavailable. But please rest assured that everyone is doing their best to find your mother.
All the same, it's not the Chateau de Versailles. It can't be that difficult to find her.
Worry not, my son. I am persuaded that we shall find the famous Sarah de Richard. No doubt with new adventures to share, huh?
What the heck?
No!
What just happened?
I should have insisted that you rest in your room.
Do you want me to
call? Did she have a vision too?
Let me handle this. I'm used to this kind of thing. Miss, can you hear me?
Leave me.
Her breathing is becoming stable and... her heart rate, too.
Pale complexion, thin, broken nails, an enormous scar on her temple, tattoos on her hands. I don't know what happened to you, Missy, but it looks like you've been through hell.
Yeah.
Can you tell me something about her?
Yeah, who is she?
Who is this young lady?
Elizabeth Adams. She's come to the island for a course of treatment. To rest.
For a course of treatment?
That's right. See her do wonders. Are you all right, Elizabeth? Do you feel any better?
When did she arrive?
4 days ago.
Okay. My mother had already gone missing.
Okay.
She's just regained consciousness and she immediately reaches for her brooch. I don't know exactly what it means to her, but obviously it's got to be something important.
Are you all right, Elizabeth? You gave us quite a fright.
Take it easy, miss.
Let me. I just need to get back to my room.
Of course, my dear. Go ahead.
You saw it, didn't you?
Pardon me? Sorry, Your Eminence. I don't speak Italian.
Forget it. It doesn't matter.
Gentlemen, it's getting late. It is time for everyone to go to bed. It's been a long day.
This is getting interesting. Really interesting.
It's all the more delicate.
I'll see what I can do, but the case I'm on at the moment might well leave me with very few opportunities.
Oh, she's on a case too.
Well, I am impressed impressed with all this splendor.
But don't spend too much time with Mr. Washington, my dear, or you'll lose your pretty accent.
That's actually kind of funny.
Absolutely. It is remarkable.
It's naughty to tell lies. Bet my life that you were talking about something totally different from the decoration of the manor. But to find out what, I should have stayed with them. Too bad.
Lord Mortimer is fond of atypical works of art. I won't disguise the fact
that I
find it
a little
megalomaniacal. But I must say, he does have some outstanding pieces.
So, who was that young lady with you?
Elizabeth Adams, Mr. President. She would have liked to have stayed with us, but the poor thing is exhausted.
Elizabeth Adams?
Just mentioning Elizabeth totally changed Washington's attitude. Looks like he just saw a ghost.
Miss Adams is here to rest. You have perhaps already...
So he either just knows her by reputation,
she arrived a few days
or he knows her personally and thought she was dead.
Rest assured, she is not here for the same reasons as yourselves. Consequently, I'm counting on your indulgence.
Washington looks surprised, but Holm doesn't seem to see it. I wonder if he's being polite or if he really doesn't see his discomfort.
On that note, it's very late. You must be exhausted. The servant will accompany you to your rooms.
I have a feeling this servant guy is going to be important later. Especially since he's the only one who we can't see who he is.
I bid you all good night. Mr. President, Your Eminence, Duchess, you have the same rooms as usual. You, Monsieur de Richet, will find your room at the end of the corridor.
Well, my friends, I am bone tired. I am off to my bed. See you in the morning.
Good night, sir. I shall do likewise.
Louis, I shall see you in the morning. Sleep well.
Good night. See you tomorrow. Oh, man. It's been quite a day. Right. Where is my room?
Let's see. Let's look around a bit and see.
Monsieur Napoleon Bonaparte.
Napoleon Bonaparte. That's a nice little Easter egg. And what's this?
Monsieur Jacques Perru. Monsieur Jacques Perru. Monsieur Jacques Perru.
Oh, okay. Okay, I must need a lockpick or something for that. Okay. Alright, let's head on back. He said my room was at the end of the corridor, so...
Duchess Emily Hillsborough.
So my room should be down this way.
Duke Manuel Godoy.
Yeah, we basically need a lockpick or something. So, maybe we'll get to do that later.
That's me.
Before we go in there, though, let's go ahead and look over here.
Monseigneur, His Eminence Cardinal Piaggi.
Okay, so just more doors we can't go into. like, why is the game not letting me move?
Right. So what shall I do with this letter? It might be about my mother's disappearance. But if I open it, I'll be betraying Piaggi's trust. What should I do?
Let's go ahead and leave it sealed for now.
Can't wait to open it, but I gave my word to Piaggi, so... Too bad. I'll wait until I hand it to Mother.
Wow. Nice room. Mortimer sure doesn't do things halfway.
Saint Jerome and the Angel. Yet again, art with political undertones with an image of a saint hearing voices. Saturn devouring his son. Again? I saw the same theme in the hall. I wouldn't like to be his son.
Nope.
The Conversion of St. Paul by Caravaggio. It's incredible. It doesn't look like a copy, but I was sure the original was in Rome. St. Francis of Assisi in Ecstasy before Superior Voices. It always amuses me to see how art gets used for propaganda purposes.
Some things never change. Oh, can't do that, unfortunately.
Carmelite water will give me a little reprieve.
Just check out that view. That is a really nice view. I imagine it would be even nicer at like a sunrise or sunset. Kind of reminds me of that moment in The Last of Us where you and Ellie can just watch the giraffes until you're ready to move on. So I can't cross over that way. And I still need a lockpick or something to open that. So, looks like we gotta head back inside. Alright, so that does it for episode 1, The Coast of England, or Off the Coast of England. And so let's look at our successes. We went up to the manor, found clues on Mother and the docks, convinced Piaggi to trust me with the letter, met with Washington, chose to go with Sir Holm in the small salon, noticed the strange talisman around Adam's neck, and we observed Sir Holm. I failed to find all the clues about my mother on the docks, and I didn't pick up the book on the quay, which I didn't know there was. Alternate paths, I could have remained with the ground in the Grand Hall to speak with Mr. Washington, which that one was obvious, so. Alright, so we already leveled up to level 2. And we need another 1210 XP to get to level 3. And so yeah, so far it looks like we're doing pretty good. Level leveling up grants me 3 efforts. So let's do... Let's go ahead and get a point in vigilance. Another questioning. Psychology. We don't have any points in agility yet, so let's go ahead and put 1 there too. Alright. Here you can choose what to read during the adventure. Each manuscript you read confers skill points at the end of the quest. What the heck?
The servants are not very efficient. Durocher can't be far away. They'll find her soon. Their search time is restricted, given that they must keep an eye on Adams.
I can take care of her.
Yes. Well, in any case, I do thank you for bringing her to the island.
Oh, there must be
from
more to
my... From what I've understood, the search of De Richet's room hasn't turned up any results.
Not yet, no. But we put her son in there. Perhaps he'll find something.
That might come in handy.
Louis grows impatient at not yet having met the famous Lord Mortimer.
He will meet him tomorrow.
Will I? Okay.
Oh, what a pity to lose a knight at the start of the game. Are you waiting for someone?
A young French soldier.
During our game of chess?
Don't worry, Gregory. The game won't disappear. I'll have one of my men escort you back.
Don't trouble yourself. I know my way out.
Ah, good evening, gentlemen. Please forgive me for this late hour.
It is never too late. And we have much to discuss. One last move?
Wow.
Don't worry.
Sore
our games
loser.
Always seem to end like this.
Or always start like this. Come, come, take a seat.
Interesting.
A little nighttime stroll, Mr. President.
There's nothing like it for a good night's sleep.
Do not hesitate to ask a servant to show you back.
The corridors seem quite safe.
Peppermint, lime flower, and valerian. My miracle remedy when one can't get to sleep. A very good night to you, Mr. Fredlin.
Thank you. And to you too, sir.
Very interesting. Okay.
I'm coming.
All right. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and stop it here, so It says we can save and return to the main menu, so we're going to stop it here for the night. I hope you all enjoyed my first ever Let's Play. I'm still really excited that I can actually do this now, so yeah. Really hope you all enjoyed this, and I will come back with the rest of this part, rest of this episode, I guess, pretty soon. So, yeah, I guess that will be all for right now. This has been Mr. Effect Films. I'm signing off. I'll see y'all later. Peace out.